What is up, everyone? This is Ken here. Welcome back again to TechKaran YouTube channel. This is Project Elixir based on Android 12. Maybe you already have heard about this one. The ROM looks quite good. The new version is out and its official update may be available for some of your devices. If you have any of these devices, you can install this. We're talking about the Android version 12 based Project Elixir version 1.1. I made a video on version 1.0 also, but now this one is 1.1. And we're going to talk about the Redmi Note 10 Pro, some device specific things also, as this is Redmi Note 10 Pro where I have installed this. Let me show you some things here. Of course, the default UI, as this is Android 12, so it was expected material U, it's there, and you can see the clock and UI looks good. This is the wallpaper which we have right now. The Volte icon is of course available if you are able to see at the status bar. So if Volte icon is available, this is something really interesting, including that as it's also based on Pixel 1. So yes, Pixel launcher was expected. It's already included here for you. Pixel launcher of course does not have any customizations right now. Only choice we have is launcher. If you don't want to use a Pixel launcher, launcher is good, but it's up to you and your user's opinion. If you want to know, if you know that in Pixel devices or Pixel Android 12 you have the black background with some different tiles and etc, but in custom ROMs like Project Elixir we have different kind of UI. We have the white background everywhere and you can see the colors looks quite impressive compared to the stock Android 12. Of course, by the way, as I've always mentioned, this is all about user's preference. The tiles which we have right now is some tiles available for you, and if you just saw the Wi-Fi and mobile data separate tile is available here for you, and this is one of my favorite features in Android 12. If you have this feature available, this looks good. Other things, let me show you some app opening, app closing speed. Here you can see, if you're able to see, this looks good. This is smooth. Of course, Redmi Note 10 Pro has 120 Hz refresh rate, so it was expected. It is there. It looks also better. Moving on to some other things, let us talk about the safety net status, which also matters a lot. If you want to use this build as your daily driver, safety status should be passed for you, and if the safety status is passing for you, you are good to go. I have installed Magisk, by the way, which means I have rooted my device, and if I have rooted my device, of course I need to hide Magisk from settings, and I already have enabled that option. So as you can see, safety status is passing for me. The device is certified. I'll be able to use banking apps on my device. Things seems to be quite good. This is a good thing about this Project Elixir custom ROM. One thing, if you're able to notice, which is quite useful, unfortunately it's not available here, Google Photos unlimited storage, you're not getting this. If you always use this feature, this is unfortunate that you'll not be able to use this feature in this custom ROM. You need to compromise with that, and if you don't do, or if you always use some offline backups etc, then this might be not a good big issue for you. Let's move on to some other things. For example, the Google Assistant. Hey Google, okay Google, these keywords are working fine. This is also quite useful, and you can see the new Google Assistant is also included. This is not the old one. So as a lot of things have been improved, things are quite good. You can see at the status bar the indicator, which means the location is accessing. So the location indication option working for you. The camera which you get here is the Google Camera Go Edition. Google Camera Go Edition, which means the Go Edition photos you will be able to click, but the thing is it's far more better than the normal snap camera which you get in AOSP. This is better. Of course, Google Camera Go Edition is there, but including that, you also have the option to use the normal separate Google camera for you. It's up to you. Moving on to some features or customizations, it doesn't come with many customizations for you, unfortunately, but features, for example, the 4G icon, Volte icon, double tap at status bar to lock screen, and else, everything else is same. These are the only features or customizations you have. This is not a customization focus based custom ROM, but you might get the customizations very soon. This is just initial build, so yes, you might not expect. Other things, let's move on to wallpapers and styles, etc. Wallpapers and style, where you can see the things like monet theming, themed icons, these things working fine. This is actually quite good, and you can see this has the modded Pixel launcher available for you, which means unlocked more grid options. The normal Pixel stock Android 12 launcher does not have these options for you. It has only less options, but this one has more options available for you, so that looks also good. This is quite useful. Everything else is just kind of same. If you want to install this build on your device, or you can install this, I'm not going to talk about that. Installation is same like other custom ROMs. I always use this feature from accessibility, like the text and speech text output, which is quite useful. I always use bold text, text and display, sorry. And like this, we have also other options available for you. Looks quite good, by the way. Bold text is one of my favorite features in Android version 12, which I always use on my device. No issues here for me. I always use this, which is just working perfectly fine. You can see I already have enabled this one. Other options or other features which I always use includes the live translate, which is also quite interesting one. I always use this one too. Gestures includes the one-handed mode, swipe to screenshot. All the useful features are available here, which you always use, and the basic features are already included. Some things which were not there, like Google Photos, unlimited storage, I've already shown you. Let me show you one thing. For example, if you want the system UI tuner and want to enable some options like show hours, time, minutes, seconds, I always use this. You can enable this in system UI tuner. You can simply enable or disable some icons if you don't want them on your status bar. So this is quite useful. Including that, you also have some device specific things. And one thing, let me show you that if we want to use the option called direct sound enhancer, this is working fine. But you need to keep one thing in mind, that you need to enable the DC dimming option. Sometimes if I use this, then I might not see the stutters and some things, but if I don't enable this option, then you might see some screen flickering issues. By the way, I will recommend you to use the high brightness instead of low brightness. Of course, this might be a bug for you, but if you want to enable it, you can. It's up to you. This is all. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.
Over the edge, feel like I'm floating through the air.